Good morning, everyone. I hope all of you guys are doing okay and that you slept well. So this morning I'm going to make our Philippine Pandesal. This is one of the best seller of our online shop. And yes, I hope you guys will like it. So first up, I'm going to show you our ingredients. We have here our ingredients, 4 cups of bread flour, 2/3 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of warm water, 1/3 cup of sugar, 2 eggs, 1/4 cup vegetable shortening. We have our 1 2/3 tablespoons of yeast, 1 teaspoon of salt, and our breadcrumbs. And now let's go ahead and mix all of the ingredients so we can start mixing our dough. First, I'm going to add our I'm going to let our yeast rise. So that our yeast will rise properly, will be activated properly, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of sugar to the milk. The milk must be warm. And then stir it. And then 1 teaspoon of flour. Let's add our yeast. Okay, so let's leave it there for about 5 minutes. Should be fine otherwise. And while waiting for our yeast to activate, let's mix our sugar to our flour. And then our salt. Let's just wait for our yeast to activate and then let's mix our dough together.
Spatula.
passed, and now we're going to we're taking out our dough. So it should be like this. It's smooth and elastic. So after that, we're going to make it into a bowl and place it again into our mixing pan, so to leave it to rise. So it should be at least double the size before we're going to make it into pieces for pandesal pieces. So we have greased our pan. So the purpose of greasing the pan is to keep our dough moist, and so it doesn't get dry. Just like this, and then let's cover our pan. Let's cover it with a cling wrap and leave it let it sit for like 15 to 20 minutes. So you can just check after 15 minutes if the dough has risen, then you can start dividing it into pieces. So I usually place this in the lit up oven, so the light is from the oven is a little bit warm, and so it will help the dough to rise faster. So usually I'm using butter instead of vegetable shortening, but today I ran out of butter, so that's why I'm using my vegetable shortening alone. Let's just wait for the dough to rise, and then after that I'm going to show you how to make the how to cut it into pieces. 15 minutes has passed, and I think our dough is now ready. Ta-da! It's more than double the size now. So what we're going to do is just take it out of the pan. Press it like that to remove a little bit of an air inside, and then divide it into half, cut it into half, and then roll it like this. So why am I doing this? So the purpose of doing this, instead of making your pandesal into a ball, you can just actually do it like this. So your pandesal will look nice when it's finished. this one is okay. Yeah. So you have to make sure that everything is the same. So when you cut it, you can have the same size. You can actually just cut it directly and you don't need to. I mean, it's up to you. If you are selling it, you can weigh it. But for me, I think I know the measurement already. And then let's proceed to the other one. So you have to seal it like this. And then like have to really push it like that. You have to roll it so the air will come out and then your pandesal will not have bubbles inside or holes inside when it's finished. Cut it into equal sizes. So here I'm going to use this. So normally I can make like 28 to 30 pieces. This one. There you go. So if you cut it like this, instead of making into a ball, you can actually have a perfect size and I mean perfect shape when you bake it. So you just and then we're just going to coat it with our breadcrumbs. Our baking pan is ready. You just have to do it like that, shape it, and then into the pan. So you don't need to like roll it and it will take time. So like this, you can just put it directly. And you can have that beautiful shape of your pandesal when it's done. it's good if your dough is not so dry and not so, what do you call this? Should be a little bit wet, a little bit moist. So your pandesal will be soft. Actually, my pandesal, I've tested it. It will last for like 5 days as long as you store it in a closed container. It will last for 5 days and it's still very soft. But if you're going to just leave it in an open air, so yes, the pandesal, of course. Any type of bread will get hard. So as you can see, the shape is really good. And then when it's done, when it is risen and then you bake it, it actually has a very beautiful finish to it. So and then we're going to cover this with our kitchen towel. So and then we leave it for like 30 minutes for the dough to rise again. Still put it in the oven. The oven is not yet heated up. It's just lit. And then the rest will also put it in the small baking pan. Okay, so we will just wait for our pandesal to rise again and then we're going to bake it. I'm gonna update you guys. After 30 minutes, our dough is now ready to bake. So let's turn on the heat to 180 degrees Celsius and we are going to bake it for like 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, our pandesal is ready, and I am just putting it in my basket with the coffee. Oh, it's amazing. Who wouldn't want to have a pandesal in the morning without?